No.
Oh, that wasn't a punt. Okay. I'm my mistake, folks. I was
they
looking
just started
at,
offense. Why would they start the punt? Now, that would be a question we were going
to
ask.
I was looking at the free safety. It looked like he was lined up to punt. But
Well, I mean, Independence is on defense now.
It's spring for us, too.
Okay, yeah. We're getting rest. We're, I mean, a little rusty. Getting out of this.
Over in East Iberville, Tommy, there must have been 30 to 40 referees out there. So this is spring for them, too. They're working on it.
Yeah.
Right. And it's hard to get mad when they blow a call because they're training, too.
Right. And I'm assuming they could probably get a new rule here once or twice
sure,
a year, you know.
Sure. So Amite on offense. Folks, this telecast made possible by Drive-In Drugstore, McNeely Funeral Home of Amite and Kentwood. Heath Martin, candidate for Tensville Parish Sheriff, Clerk of Court Gary Stanga, Vivo CPR, Big Frog Custom Tees and more. Tensville Parish Councilman, Mr. Louis Joseph, who we will be talking to shortly. Jim's Paint, Body and Glass. I know Mr. Jim very well. Go see Mr. Jim. Does a great job. And David Ritter, candidate for Tensville Parish Council, District 4. Thank you very much. Without these folks, we wouldn't have this all-star lineup up here in the stands at Independence.
Hey, guys, y'all mind if we have a special guest join us before Mr. Joseph?
Yeah, please you do. Should ask the all-stars right here. We're going to let you do it. We're going to let you do it.
Well, we got a guy who is naturally from Independence who went on and played pro ball. He's joined us. Mr. Lockett, we're going to get you to step over there where you can hear them.
Mr. Frank Lockett. Formerly of the New Orleans Breakers and the old USFL.
Old USFL. they just started a new USFL and trying to get used to the Breakers.
Yes, sir.
Actually, now, I own all the records for the receiving records for the Breakers.
Yes, sir.
And do they still count with the new one since they did
yes,
the new
still
league?
Count
they're still
with
there?
The, yeah,
that's awesome.
Still, yeah.
And what years were you there, Mr. Lockett?
From 83 to 85.
Oh, I
was in Boston, New Orleans, and Portland. I was transferred to traded to San Antonio Gunslingers. So
I was just
my
a whippersnapper at the time, but I watched the Breakers, and I'm sure I've seen you do your thing many times.
Well, I'm from Independence. I left here when I was like 9 or 10 years old in like 1968. He's gone all the way. Got called at the 10-yard line.
And that was
like the
for Tresman Richardson,
I think.
Number 14.
4-yard line?
Yeah, about that.
And we were talking about spring football and the formats, how they do the structure, the so many plays per side, per unit, ones,
right,
twos,
right,
threes.
Right.
And then I think we're going to have a live-action quarter at the end.
Okay.
It's not quite like preseason football. Now did USFL, did they have a preseason as well?
Yeah, we had a preseason. It was kind of short, I think, 2 games. We had a scrimmage against Herschel Walker. Wasn't really a scrimmage at all.
Now, he was with the Generals, is that right?
He was with the Generals.
That's right.
Yeah.
The other thing that we can compare it to is this is a time for kids to make their mark.
Yes.
Just like the rookies in the pros.
Yeah.
They come out to these things, and they want to go all out. They want to make the team. So
right.
They're going to give max effort, which some of these younger kids that are trying to get starting positions are trying to do the same.
Yeah. Well, I was in that position when I played in junior high and high school, you know. You have to get yourself mentally and physically prepared. You got to have good backing with the family and all. But it's one day at a time, one day at a time.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Now, have the Breakers been in contact with you? I mean, are you still close to the program?
No, I live in New Orleans, in Harvey, Louisiana.
Yes, sir.
I've been living in New Orleans for the last 30 years. After I played football, I worked at the mental health field with the homeless in New Orleans.
Yes, sir.
So I haven't heard from them yet, but they haven't moved to New Orleans yet.
Where are they right now?
Birmingham. Yeah.
And I think it's taking people a little while to embrace it, but I think they'll catch back on.
Oh, yeah, it'll catch back on. They have so many football players in this country that needs jobs, you know, that will play anywhere. I started off in, when I went to Nebraska, I got drafted by the Packers. After I got drafted by the Packers, I went to play in California League.
That was Byron Jennings on the Amite touchdown. Mr. Lockett punching that one in from
yes,
short
sir,
distance.
Yes, sir.
Now, Randy Whitney right here next to you is the head coach at the South Louisiana Demons, which is a semi-pro team.
Semi-pro
Randy, would you like to talk about
yes.
that?
I mean, ain't much to talk about. I mean, compared to what you've done, you know? I mean,
well, I played semi-pro too in California League.
Yeah.
And it helped me to advance to the next, you know.
It does, but man, nowadays, and you get the good teams. You get the good semi-pro teams in certain states and stuff. And then you've got ones that actually lay a bad foundation for the semi-pro and some of the athletes that are coming out. I try to do better by that and help. I try to do my best to get these guys looked at. I got a lot of friends that are other coaches, other places all over the South Louisiana area.
Yeah.
But it's so hard for some of these kids that come out that don't get looked at and don't get seen to find a place. And there's so many options, you know, for them to go to. You know, having a semi-pro team that, you know.
Pass to the left. Drop.
Having a semi-pro team that these kids could probably fall into.
Yes.
I look at it as it helps them, you know.
Right.
And plus, I love football, so it's just fun to do. So,
well, it's another avenue, semi-pro. It really helped me because I had played in California League. I played on the worst team in the league, and I was most valuable player.
Right.
I had 1,000 yards return, 1,000 yards receiving. It's just a place I wanted to be at and a place that, you know, that I kind of like helped me out. And I think I got signed by the 49ers.
Nice.
Right now, quarterback for Independence is Weatherspoon. That's Jamarcus. Ms. Lockett, we saw him emerge as a freshman last year during the Albany game and showed flashes of he could be a really good player. And I know Coach Shaffet is high on him. He's taking reps with the number twos right now.
Right.
Now, look, this is still early. The season hasn't started. He could be number one before the season begins.
Yes,
so
yes. I'm quite
all
sure.
All he's got to do is go in there,
grass.
Put his nose down, and get to work.
We got to meet your cousin before we went on the air.
Okay.
His name escapes me right now. Yeah.
Right.
I met him downstairs.
Well, he said he was coming. I was coming.
He's here. Yeah, and he said Frank Lockett's my cousin.
Roger right there?
If I see him, I'll know him.
Oh, he's a player?
No.
Well, that's probably him. That's my cousin.
Yes,
right
sir.
There.
That's him.
Yeah. He has a son out there, number 15.
I'm now, sure. I believe he played. Did he play for Coach Bags or was it Coach Corona?
I'm not sure.
And who was your coach when you were at Independence?
I never played for Independence.
Oh, I thought. Oh, you're from Independence.
I'm from Independence. I left Independence when I was like 6 years old. I went to Berger Junior High School.
And where is that?
Independence.
Berger.
Berger Junior High School.
Oh, in California.
No.
It's here?
Independence. It was Berger Junior High School. We had a junior high school and we had a high school. Okay, and back then, everything kind of merged together with the, integration and all.
Yes, sir.
You know, the school integrated black and white. And they became Independent High, that first I know.
Now, you're only 22, 23. Don't give us a story.
Well, I just learned something new.
I did not know that.
So thank you for that.
I know a lot of history here. I mean,
well, you just taught me something. Weatherspoon takes a snap. Looking to throw out into the flat.
So let me ask you a question.
Complete. They are going to call
that complete.
We're
going to have some of these players watching this later on with their parents. We're going to have parents watching this. These kids they got to have some kind of, I don't know, I guess control over themselves when it comes to being on the field.
Yes, sir.
The way they listen to the coaches, the way they act.
Uh-huh.
What would you give advice to these kids that are wanting to go to another level, to want a college to look at them? What do they need to do to grasp at, to have people want to look at them and see them? What kind of advice would you give them?
Well, the thing I think, it starts at home with the parents and with that to integrate that with their schoolwork and things like that in school. If you can listen to your mom and dad and you go to class and listen to your teachers and your people that you look up to, that's the first thing. You know, these kids today, they're out of control. They're doing what they want to do. They don't listen to the parents. I don't know what to say about all that, but people with guns and all this kind of stuff are
right.
Kids. But the main thing is you got to want it.
Right.
You know, you got to want it. Your mom and daddy can't hold your hand for the rest of your life. You have to get out here and go to school, lift weights, go to tutoring, and be the best person you could be.
We were just discussing that last night, Mr. Lockett. I believe kids want the discipline.
They want it.
They may complain about it, but they know if you're putting the hammer down on them, you care about them.
Yeah. I worked with homeless kids in New Orleans for 20-some years, and I've seen, you know, from 12 to 13 years old out in the streets taking care of themselves. And in the streets, prostituting, drug dealing, and all this kind of stuff. The parents are nowhere around. A lot of these kids get pulled out the gutters. Some of them make it, some of them don't.
And as coaches, we kind of become de facto parents.
Right.
And in my opinion, I mean, it's not my opinion. It's I'm sure it's yours as
it's
well.
It's the truth.
The kids need to know that you truly care about them.
Right.
And if you don't, and you got BS with you, they're going to see right through you.
Well, when I was coming up, I was scared of my mother.
Me
you know,
too.
More than I was scared of the police.
I still am.
And these kids, they're not scared of anyone. I mean, anybody. Mother, father, sister, brother.
Weatherspoon.
Woo! Good.
Now,
it's Jaden Anderson. Nice game by the Tigers.
I like that play because he had two options. He had the deep and he had the short, and he stayed safe and went short.
And what I've noticed in my short 7 years, of course, you were in the game. You were in the game way longer than I'll probably ever be.
Yeah.
But the kids, when they buy into you and they know you got their back, you know, they know you have their best interest in mind.
Yes, sir.
You don't have to yell at them. You don't have to cuss at them.
No.
When you say, son, you really disappointed me, that hits them in the chest.
That's it. Hits
they
them in the chest.
They do not want to let you down.
Right, right. And being a coach, I've been a coach before and all that kind of stuff. And kids from 8 to 9 years old will look up to you. And they will say, look here, Mr. Frank, I need your help. I need your help doing this. I need your help at home, whatever. And my job is to get to the bottom of it.
Yes, sir. Well, I'm officially extending you an invitation.
Okay.
Come out to Hammond High this fall.
Okay.
I'd love you to come talk to our kids.
Okay, yeah.
And I teach JAG, as Tommy was pointing out, which is Jobs for America's Graduates.
Right, right.
It's a federal program.
Right.
And we teach life skills.
Right. I've done that for many years, life skills. Homeless people I work with, teaching them life skills, that type of thing.
Hey, as long as we're in a break, I'm going to step in for Randy for just a moment. I was telling Randy, Randy's too young to remember the original USFL, but one of the best games I've ever seen in my life was in late May 1983, before the Breakers came to New Orleans. Do you remember what game I'm talking about? Who was the hero of the Stars game and what happened? Tell us about that. We don't have any action on the field, so.
Well, I've never, talking here? I've never caught a pass that game. No passes the whole game. I mean, I'm running down the field, getting open, and all this kind of stuff. And so the last play of the game, I run down the field, looked in the – I was just standing in the end zone. Just standing in the end zone, the ball pops out, and comes right in my hand.
Come on.
And I wins the game. It was like DeFranco Harris that
the
played
it. Immaculate reception.
Immaculate reception. And at the time, it was the coach that used to coach the Saints back in the day. Jim Moore. Jim Moore hated me.
Why?
Because every time we played him, I scored a touchdown. And so what happened was
so he hated you out of respect.
Yeah. And so what happened was I moved to New Orleans. So I said, my agent called Jim Moore and said, Frank needs a job. He gave me an opportunity, but he signed some guy, other guy, and he never panned out.
He messed up.
Yeah.
He should have signed you.
Yeah.
And you see a batted pass by the defensive end there, number 31, which is what we teach our linemen. You can't get to that quarterback. Get your hands up.
What I'm liking right now is the Amite defensive ends are staying home. They're not pressing too hard.
Yes.
And they're good size, too, on top of that.
Well, Amite look like they undersized a little bit, and they're, like, short of players, too, out here. Just the varsity here?
Yes, sir. I think Independent has about 30.
I think they bought their JV in varsity.
And Amite has about 70 to 80.
Okay.
Of course, this is spring, and this may wide open.
Good job. Good job.
Weatherspoon drops it in the bucket to number 4. Mikey Bean, senior running back.
Oh, Bean, from last season.
As Tommy pointed out, player of the week twice for us.
Player of the week.
Yeah. He's a player.
Yeah.
Yes, he is.
I was checking out number 74 and number 78 of Independence. That's pretty good size boys there.
Yes, sir. 50s. Got pretty good size.
Yeah.
We have a D end over at Hammond, Corey Smith, and he's pushing 6'6".
6'6".
Why are you plugging Hammond players there, buddy?
I told my guys I'd mention their names a few times. A few of them might come up and talk to us for the night's over with. But, yes, sir, we would be honored for you to come out and talk to our
kids.
And,
you know, I went to Nebraska, and Nebraska moved to the Big Ten, and they just ain't getting the Big Ten players these days. Big Ten players 6'6", 6'8". 350 pounds coming out of high school, you know, just Bogart people.
Yes, sir. I was just getting ready to ask you. You played for the immortal Tom Osborne.
Tom Osborne. Yes, and so he came to my house and recruited me in California. And I seen him 40 years later. And when our friends died, I went to the funeral. I was sitting by him. I said, "Hey, Tom." He said, "Who are you?" I said, "You don't remember me?"
But he's probably seen now. Thousands of faces.
Oh, yeah. He's a great coach, though.
I have one Tom Osborne story for you.
Uh-huh.
Good friend of mine, Darren Landry, Boo Boo Landry from Ponchatoula.
Okay.
Went on to play at LSU. Was an offensive lineman there in the late 80s into the early 90s. But in his recruitment, Nebraska wanted him, specifically Tom Osborne.
Uh-huh.
We were watching the Orange Bowl at Darren's house.
Right.
And his phone rang. Before the Orange Bowl, and it's
Tom,
Coach Osborne.
Yeah.
He said, "Darren, this is Coach Osborne. I was just calling to see if you were watching the game." And
right,
he was like,
right.
"Yes, sir."
Yeah.
That's recruiting right there.
Oh, yeah.
If that's not enough, Nebraska was handling their business.
Yeah.
And at halftime, the phone rings again. At halftime.
Yeah.
And it's Coach Osborne again asking Darren, did he see anything on the
game
film? What adjustments could they make?
Right.
And amazingly, Darren decided to go to LSU.
Okay.
If he'd have gone to Nebraska, he'd have two rings on his hand.
Yeah.
But he bleeds purple and gold, and he wasn't going to be deterred.
I think if I would have stayed in Independence and I would have, pursued my football career or whatever, I probably wanted to go to LSU somewhere like that. I got recruited by Nebraska, all 1,500 schools, you know.
Yes, sir.
But when I went to Nebraska on a recruiting trip, it was snowing. And that was something different. And the lifestyle was kind of a little slower from California, so it was a blessing.
We had a good many kids from last year's. We had 22 seniors last year in Hammond, and a good many of them have gone to play. Now, no real major schools, but these smaller schools, don't sleep on them.
Right. It doesn't matter where you go. If you stand out, the scout's going to follow you.
Absolutely
right.
Correct.
Hi, this is David Ritter, and I'm running for Parish Council District 4. I want to wish good luck to both teams tonight as they play football, also in the upcoming football season. I also want to remind them in this district is Natobene, Tickfa, Independence, and Laranja. So remember us in October, please.
Drive-In Drugstore, locally owned and operated for over 50 years, providing quality personalized pharmaceutical customer services for the Amite community. They are at 228 South First Street. You can give them a call at 985-748-8307, or you can find them online at driveindrugstore.com.
Gerald and the crew say, "Go Warriors!"
This is Greg McNeely at McNeely Funeral Home wishing the Warriors a great season. Go Warriors!
Coverage of the Amite Independence Spring Game is made possible by Gary Stanger, Tangipahoa Parish Clerk of Court. Gary Stanger, trusted experience.
Gems Paint, Body and Glass is a family-owned and operated auto repair business that has been serving the area since 2009. Their goal is to provide high-quality repairs to all of our customers. They provide a high level of communication throughout the auto repair process. Gems also does Louisiana state inspections. That's Gems Paint, Body and Glass, Durbin Road in Independence.
Hello to all of the citizens of Parish Council District 3. This is Louis Nick Joseph, advising you all that I am throwing my hat in the ring for Parish Council for the final time, as we are term limited after this election. Be further advised that due to redistricting, the village of Tangipahoa and all of the city limits of Kentwood have been added to my district. I humbly ask you for your vote and your support as we continue in our effort to improve the quality of life for all of the citizens of Tangipahoa Parish. May God continue to bless you and your family. Thank you very much.
Big Frog Custom T-Shirt and More specializes in direct-to-garment printing on custom T-shirts and apparel. Big Frog offers custom apparel at affordable prices with no minimums, no setup fees. free graphic design, and quick turnarounds. Big Frog custom t-shirts and more. Southwest Railroad in Hammond.
Vivo CPR provides CPR and first aid training to your group on your schedule at your chosen location. We'll bring the training to your office, construction site, church, hospital, daycare, summer camp, school, wharf, or to your TWIC facility. Anytime, anywhere. Saving lives matters. Vivo CPR.
Hello, Tanshapa Ho. This is Heath Martin, candidate for sheriff. I'm happy to bring you this high school football game. Come out and join us in July for our meet and greet at Serenity Sands on the beautiful Tanshapa River. You can find the information on any of my social media platforms. Now let's sit back and enjoy the game.
Welcome back. We're continuing with Mr. Frank Lockett, record holder for the New Orleans Breakers from back in the day.
Back in the day. Boy, those are some good days, man. It's like they really gave me an opportunity to come out and play ball. And, you know, I think I had over 1,500 yards total in my career in the 3 years there. And we had a quarterback, Johnny Walton, bless his soul.
I remember that name.
Johnny, what was it, Johnny Unitas? Yeah.
What a great football name, Johnny Walton.
But he thought he was Johnny Unitas. That's what he, you know. But, yeah, his throwing motion was like, gone, ball gone. Yeah.
I was actually in the Superdome the night Drew Brees broke Johnny U's record.
Okay.
So that was kind of a special moment. So we have Amite with their number twos on offense right now. At quarterback for Amite, we have number 12, Jeremy Franklin.
The bump. Oh, come on.
Deep throw. That was a bad pass.
Beautiful pass.
Touched his hand. You got to catch that one.
He threw it where there was no way that defender was going to pick it off.
Yeah, that's where you want it at. You want that ball right where the defender can't get to it. Either anytime
you throw. Pass by the quarterback.
Now, we don't have classifications on the Independence players. Amite players. We have Independence. I'm looking at the Independence roster. It looks like they have maybe a dozen seniors on this team.
Okay, Independence.
Yes, sir. And how much of a factor, in your opinion, what role does that play, the amount of seniors you have on that team?
It pays quite a toll, you know, during the season. At the oh, my God. Oh, fumble!
That fumble is recovered by number 50, Cordell Hines. You were just talking about him, and he has good size. That ball got stripped. That play looked weird from jump. Did the running back pitch it back?
I'm not sure.
I think I missed that one.
Looks like the running back hit the line and then pitched it back, and then the other back took it.
He was carrying the ball in the wrong arm in the wrong place.
Yes, sir. And, of course, these are the things Coach Shaffet will
Coach Powell will
look at and correct.
Well, like the question you just asked me about the seniors, I think it's about football players. You know, if you get them in there when they're young, eighth, ninth grade, and teach them, you know, I could have started varsity in ninth grade, eighth grade. But I was an All-American wrestler, too, and All-American football player, you know, in California. So, it benefits you.
Are you a firm believer in best 11 on the field, regardless of classification?
Best 11 on the field. If you want to win now.
Yes, sir.
You get the lead and you put the younger guys in and let them get some experience, you know, the line.
Your first 11 should always understand that if they're not getting the job done, there's somebody back there that's going to get it done.
Take the place.
There's somebody back there that's going to listen better than you.
Yeah.
That's going to do the things that are told if you don't do them because they want that
spot.
And
if you're not doing that, the guys in front of them, they're just going to do what they want to do and play when they want to play.
Exactly.
Yes, I played for Ponce Tula 84 through 88.
Uh-huh.
I was not a very good football player.
Yeah.
I was more of a baseball player. But
Right.
And I'll be honest, I was one of those kids that when I was a freshman, I thought if I had that uniform and helmet on, I'd get the girls.
Yes.
And then the work started. And
yes.
I said, you know, if I'm going to put in all this work, I want to play.
Yeah.
So I paid attention at practice. I kept my helmet strapped up and ready to go. And when I saw my opportunity, I went out there and – busted my behind. Next thing you know, I'm playing special teams. And that's one of the messages I give to our kids. be ready.
Yeah, but you know what I always think, you know, I'm from Independence. When I left Independence, I didn't have a pair of shoes, like talking about. We didn't play, we ran in the woods and all this kind of stuff with no shoes on, played football with no shoes on, and that type of thing. When I got a chance to play football, my mother moved us to California. So
you grew up through the 60s, through the civil rights movement and the integration.
So you didn't grow up vegan?
No.
Not like it is now.
No.
We show the movie Remember the Titans to our
players. Remember the Titans.
Yeah.
That reminds me of the country style football there.
And there's just so many good messages in there.
Yeah.
That black and white together.
Right.
Bonded as a team.
Yeah.
It's hard to beat that.
But when I left here, it was like integration was really going on. 68, the school merges together and all that kind of stuff. My mother really didn't want us to experience that. But, you know, it is what it is. And when I came back to Louisiana first time after that, I drove right through Independence. You know, in my mind, I thought it was a big town.
Mm-hmm.
I seen one red light.
Right.
I said, I must be lost. So I turned around and went back. Because I was born right there on 51 right by the hospital.
They got Piggly Wiggly and everything.
For those who don't know, if you're not from the South, the Piggly Wiggly is a big thing in these small towns.
Yes.
That pass complete to Jonathan Franklin picks up the first down. One of the things that Denzel Washington said in that movie, I don't know if it was a direct quote from Coach Boone, but he said, the rest of the teams in our league are all white. They don't have to worry about race. We do. But we're better for it.
Yeah. But, you know, I played in those times, you know, when it was like the teams I played on was all black and the team was all white. And, you know, it was like a race riot almost, you know, the game.
Yes.
Just, you know, until the time came on and everybody respected everybody, you know. And it's
long overdue.
Long overdue.
I'm a big baseball fan myself. I'll say it. You look at the records that went up from Ty Cobb, from Babe Ruth, you know, all these things. It just makes me wonder if Major League Baseball was integrated back then, would they have even posted those stats? Babe have hit all those home runs off Satchel Paige?
Right.
So, to me, some of those records are kind of skewed.
Yeah, it's kind of skewed. Because, I mean, when they came in, they had all these records, and they didn't really allow them to break them. You know?
Right. Yes. And, of course, it's a different game today.
Yeah.
It's hard to compare the game in the 60s to the game in the 2020s.
Right.
Had a little injury there.
You're speaking baseball. I grew up in California. I played ball with Willie McGee. Willie McGee, Cardinals?
For the Cardinals, yes.
Yeah. He's from my high school.
Yeah, that was a heck of a team they had that year.
Yeah, he played for the Yankees in St. Louis. Then he went to the Giants to finish the season.
That was Willie McGee, Terry Pendleton.
Yeah.
What a team.
Shake it off.
So we are going to – Randy has to change his batteries. That happens when you get older. So, Mr. Lockett, thank you so much for visiting with us. And like I said –
get back with me. I'll come and check you guys out.
I'll get your number from Tommy, and maybe this fall you come talk to our boys. So we'd be honored to have you.
Hello to all of the citizens of Parish Council District 3. This is Louis Nick Joseph advising you all that I am throwing my hat in the ring for Parish Council for the final time, as we are term limited after this election. Be further advised that due to redistricting, the village of Tangipahoa and all of the city limits of Kentwood have been added to my district. I humbly ask you for your vote and your support as we continue in our effort to improve the quality of life for all of the citizens of Tangipahoa Parish. May God continue to bless you and your family. Thank you very much.
Drive-In Drugstore. Locally owned and operated for over 50 years, providing quality personalized pharmaceutical customer services for the Amite community. They are at 228 South First Street. You can give them a call at 985-748-8307, or you can find them online at driveindrugstore.com.
Gerald and the crew say, go Warriors!
coverage of the Amite Independence Spring Game is made possible by Gary Stanger, Tangipahoa Parish Clerk of Court. Gary Stanger, trusted experience.
Gems Paint, Body and Glass is a family-owned and operated auto repair business that has been serving the area since 2009. Their goal is to provide high-quality repairs to all of our customers. They provide a high level of communication throughout the auto repair process. Gems also does Louisiana state inspections. That's Gems Paint, Body and Glass, Durbin Road in Independence.
Hi, this is David Ritter, and I'm running for Parish Council, District 4. I want to wish good luck to both teams tonight as they play football, also in the upcoming football season. I also want to remind them, in this district is Natobene, Tickfa, Independence, and Laranja. So remember us in October, please.
This is Greg McNeely at McNeely Funeral Home wishing the Warriors a great season. Go Warriors!
Hello, Tangipahoa. This is Heath Martin, candidate for sheriff. I'm happy to bring you this high school football game. Come out and join us in July for our meet and greet at Serenity Sands on the beautiful Tangipahoa River. You can find the information on any of my social media platforms. Now let's sit back and enjoy the game.
All right, we're back to action. That's a deep pass. Oh, and that's going to be a touchdown. Mikey Beam, senior running back.
Did our cameraman just miss that? Okay, so there was a touchdown. We apologize for the
It's spring training for Tommy, too. It's okay. You know, we relate. Tommy missed a touchdown.
All the other camera people missed it, too. So, you know, we're good.
Well, they've got a power issue, I believe, in the press box currently. But, you know, I'm looking at this field, Randy. I keep referring to Hammond High, but in that 6-5A district, everyone in that district has turf fields except Ponchatoula High School and Hammond High School. You go west to Livingston, and outside of Springfield, Albany, all those schools have turf fields. So I'm wondering when our turn's coming.
I think I heard through the grapevine that it was coming. Somebody told me that. I can't remember. I can't tell you who it was or because I got to remember. That's why. But I did hear that we had that discussion that was coming. But when though, I don't know how. You know, when it could be in the next year or so. It could be longer.
Now I did hear on ESPN radio the other day that the NFL is wanting to peel back from the turf fields. They want to go back to grass.
Assuming more injuries coming off the turf is what they're trying to say.
Yeah.
But in my opinion, and this is from I've played, you played, I love grass fields. I think they're great. They got a lot to give. Problem is when it rains, that's where injuries come in with the mud.
Sure is. And now we're going to be joined by a man I deeply respect, Mr. Lewis Joseph.
How's it going?
How you doing, sir?
All right, son. How are you?
How's it going?
How's it going?
Good.
Good, how you guys doing?
Mr. Joseph, he's ex this, ex that. He was our superintendent for a long time. Good friends with my father. And numerous times I heard my dad say how much he respected and admired you.
Bob and I were good friends, and we both educators and both military guys, so Vietnam veterans. So, yes, and look, he's deeply missed, so I really admire Bob.
I never thought I would get into teaching, Mr. Joseph. I, after hearing my parents come home from school on a Friday, I was like, oh, my God, I'm never doing that. But I guess it's in your blood.
Well, I tell you, man, a lot of times we have a tendency to fall in the footsteps of our parents. You know, your doctor's kids become doctors, teacher's kids become teachers, you know. So that's the way it goes. That's a good thing.
I love it.
Yeah, great.
You know,
so where are you at Hammond
High? I'm at Hammond High School.
Good job.
Yeah. Just finishing up my seventh year. We have about 6.5 days left.
Yeah,
I think we look more forward to the summer than the kids do. But we're in the middle of LEAP testing right now. Now, when you were superintendent, was LEAP in at that point?
Oh, yeah. Oh, of course. Yeah,
when did
was.
That come in, Mr. Joseph?
That came in, I would say, close to about 10 years ago. It started testing, yeah. And we called it grade level proficiency at that time. Then it turned into LEAP. So it's been around a while. And they're trying to test the skill level of the kids and also the effectiveness of the teachers as well. So it was win-win for everybody, Matt.
And I teach the JAG program over at Hammond High School. That's Jobs for America's Graduates. And walking by us right now is Mr. Jeff Johnson, who is the Amite JAG instructor.
Okay.
Yeah. Up this way.
I've been knowing Reverend Jeff for a long time.
How you doing, Jeff?
Jeff is also a veteran. Yeah. Captain Jeff.
How you doing, Jeff?
Yeah.
I've been Jeff, good to
Jeff
see you.
For a long time.
Always good to see you. Yeah. Early football. Actually.
Yes, sir.
Got the look.
Jag's,
your blood.
Jag sending us to Louisville, Kentucky for national training this year.
Outstanding.
Yeah,
outstanding.
Also.
So you're going to come with me to the bat-making factory?
Bat-making?
Yeah, the Louisville Slugger.
Look, I just give you one of those.
Yeah, that should be a great trip.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Sir. You know, that's a place we don't normally go.
Right.
And as I said, 7 years. Jeff's the same way. Jag has been in Tangipahoa Parish for 7 years. It's still not all over Louisiana. Livingston Parish doesn't have any programs yet.
No.
Not every state has it as well. We're up to what, about 40 states with
states.
Jag?
And yes, sir. And I think I heard that, Mr. Matt, that they're moving one to Kentwood.
Okay. And Governor Edwards was our national chairman.
Oh, yes.
Right.
And I think he's just now stepping down.
Right.
That's right.
Years.
Yeah.
He's been our greatest supporter.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir. Because first thing he did once he got in office, he put a JAG program at his alma mater.
Right.
Right.
So we better walk the line. Huh? Yeah.
You know, you got to love it, though. This is the best kept secret. People just don't know enough about JAG.
Well, you would think the Board of Elementary and Secondary Education would make that a priority for all the schools in the state.
Yes, sir.
I mean, it's a great program.
It's an excellent program.
Yeah, yeah.
And Mr. Joe, it's one of the crucial programs for the kids on Jumpstart. You know, the kids that take Jumpstart, this falls as one of their credentials, mandatory credentials. So
okay.
That's a blessing for them.
No doubt about it.
So that makes us even more of a, put a greater need on us.
Yes, sir.
Exactly right.
And I just added up our grants and scholarship money for my 16 seniors in JAG I had this year. We totaled up almost $172,000 in scholarships and grants for our JAG kids.
That's what you say when you get that kind of money. The program pays for itself.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Outstanding.
And we wouldn't have it if it weren't for people like Mr. Joseph as precursors to all of this.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Well, stand it up for them because that's what they see. They don't see us.
Yeah.
And Mr. Joseph, I'm looking at your hat, and I have to say thank you for your service. How many tours in Vietnam did you do?
I did one tour. I was there from 65 to 66. And we left Okinawa. I was stationed in Okinawa for 18 months. And, of course, then we declared the war, so I left Okinawa in my unit and went straight to Vietnam. I was there for 11 months and 17 days.
Oh. Lord.
Well, we're so glad you made it through.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I think Dad was there in 67, 68.
Yeah.
He was at Comron.
Uh-huh.
Navy radio man.
Oh. I also had three brothers who served in Vietnam.
Oh,
really?
So my mother did a lot of praying.
Oh,
brother.
I bet.
Yeah.
So is that all your brothers?
I have six brothers, and we all served in the military.
Praise
God. In the U.S. Army.
No, I didn't know that though, the long time.
Oh, yeah. Everyone
that makes
served.
Me think of Saving Private Ryan that story where all the brothers started getting killed. They had to go find Ryan to get him out.
To save the bloodline.
Well, I had lunch with the Adjutant General today, General Baudel, and I was telling him about my military career. So I said, you know how it is, my oldest brother went in first, and we like little ducklings follow, right?
Yes,
one after another.
Well, praise God.
But let me tell you something. That's one of the best decisions I ever made. If I had to do it all over again, I would start with the military. It's
praise
a great place to start.
Yes,
you're not
is.
Going to college, go to military.
Yes.
And that's stuff we teach in JAG.
Yes.
I mean, when we were growing up, we were taught you graduate high school, you go to college.
Right.
And that doesn't work for everybody.
No.
So we push the trade schools and military service.
Yes,
sometimes
right.
The kids just need to go into the workforce and realize what they want to do with their lives, pay some bills, figure life out a little bit, and then get their priorities straight.
And some kids just need discipline.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
and we discussed that earlier. That kids want discipline.
I really believe that. They want you to show some type of direction for them.
That's right.
It takes away the stress off of them.
And football is a great outlet
to bring that in.
Oh, yeah.
They can get a whole lot of stress out here.
I was telling somebody earlier today, football is a game with a physical activity, but also mental as well.
Yes, sir.
You know, you have to be even keel on both sides of the ball. Yeah. It's a great, great, great game. Teaches a lot of discipline.
And you, as a football player, that carries a lot of responsibility. You're held to a higher standard. We expect you to be leaders not only on the field but in the hallways. When you step out of line, the other students look at you and say, he's a football player.
Right.
And what kind of example is that showing?
That's right. And when the coach says, be here for 3 o'clock, practice on Saturday, be here for 3 o'clock, not 3:30.
Yes,
discipline.
Yes.
And if you're on time, you're late.
Yeah.
That's military right there.
That's military.
If you're early, you're on time.
When the Gulf War broke out, my grandfather was in World War II. Of course, Dad was in Vietnam. And I know you're going to say, Greer, you're crazy. But I was at the time. I was young and dumb. And I couldn't wait to go. I wanted to go. It was my turn. You know, it was like an honor.
Right.
And Ansel Stroud, General Stroud was the admiral at the time.
General Stroud, yes.
And so some of us filled out volunteer paperwork. He wouldn't let any of us go individually. You're going as a unit or you're not going.
That's right.
And I was so upset. And my dad sat me down and he said, you don't know what you're asking for. Believe me. I respect the gung-ho attitude.
Yeah.
Let a bullet whiz by your ear. You'll be second-guessing that thought, that thought process.
But that was a great decision on your part, though. Great decision.
I valued my military service. If I did anything wrong, Mr. Jovis, I shouldn't have got out. I should have stayed in.
I encourage a lot of the guys who get out early to rethink it. Some of them went back in, and when I see them now, they retired, and they can't stop thanking me for it.
That was one mistake I made. When my 6-year enlistment came up, I called it quits.
Yeah.
If I had to do it over again, I'd have stayed in.
Uh-huh. But you were willing to serve, though, Matt. You did well. You're willing to serve.
And we talked about that, too, with football players and the risk to injury. And these kids understand. When they take that physical and they get on that football field, they can get hurt.
Right.
They understand this. When soldiers go to war.
You could.
When you put your hand on that Bible for your oath, you knew one day Uncle Sam could ask you to go put your life on the line.
That's no doubt about it.
So don't feel sorry for us. Mm-hmm. We volunteer.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And that's what makes us the best fighting force on the planet.
That's right. And look, when we take that oath, we knew what we were getting into.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah, we weren't forced to get in. And look, I got to tell you, we'll do it again. If I go right now, they take me.
I'm sure.
I'm going to tell you, that's a strange one. But, you know, as old as we are, you know, I think about that myself. The folks that want to volunteer, I say, man, look, you don't have, it is an honor to volunteer.
It is.
That's right.
And
it
for the countries honor. That where there are people are forced to serve, their heart isn't in it.
Their heart is
right. Right. There you go.
That probably means they're not going to do their best.
That's right. There you go. But there you go.
This is something that's very unique. It's a unique brotherhood.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. A unique brotherhood.
Mm-hmm. I remember guys from basic training.
Oh,
we went to tech school. One of my roommates, his name was Doug Green from Detroit, and he messaged me on Facebook like 3 days ago. I haven't seen that guy in 20-something years.
God, have mercy.
And it just filled my heart up to hear from him.
Well, the military is a fraternity. It's a bond. Yeah. You know, I mean. You get together, you got the same objective.
Yeah.
That's why we all hang together.
Yeah.
Yes, and respect each other.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, I asked Dad, of course, he was Navy at the time. I said, was the Navy-Marine Corps rivalry as serious? He goes, oh, yeah.
Uh-huh.
he said, I'll tell you what, son. He said, did I like the Marines? Not that much. But I respected the hell out of them.
Yeah.
And your behind wouldn't be standing here if it weren't for Marines saving my life.
Yeah. First to fight.
Yeah.
I like that statement for saving his life.
Yeah. Right. Uh-huh. Well, it's that brotherhood. It's kind of like, you know, your brother at home. You can hit him.
Yeah.
You can pick on him. Uh-huh. You call him names, but let somebody else do it.
That's right.
The military's kind of the same way, you know.
Yeah.
The Army can mess with the Air Force. The Marines can mess with Navy. But let somebody else do it, and we're going to have a problem.
And when crunch time, we function as one.
Yes, sir.
Yes, indeed.
Mm-hmm. So we got another break in the action. We got laundry on the field. Number twos. So we're talking to Mr. Louis Joseph, ex-superintendent of schools for Tansville Parish. And how's your relationship with Miss Stilley? Do you know her well?
Oh, yeah. Melissa and I are close. Whenever I hear a program that she may be interested in, I give her a call. I'll send people. Some of them still call me, these companies. They don't know you. You're not superintendent anymore. So when they do call me, and what I know on the parish council, I refer that to Melissa. Especially when it comes to STEM money and stuff like that.
Definitely.
Projects she may be interested in. And then, you know, she gives me credit. And I tell her, you don't have to give me any credit at all, but I do it for the kids.
Yes, yes.
I'm still interested in our school district.
A lot of positive things going on in Tansville Parish.
No doubt about it.
No doubt.
Yeah.
And that's kudos to our administration, our school board. And the teacher doing the grunt work in the classrooms. I'm surrounded by some dynamite teachers.
Well, I stay in contact with, on the political side with the governor's office and his chief of staff, Troy Taylor, and I'm constantly pushing that please don't let our teachers down. They need the pay raise.
Oh yeah,
big time. And the governor told me he's fighting as hard as he can to get that pay raise.
I'll tell you.
And not only get us to the national average, but keep us at the national average.
Maintain it,
yeah. Which means you got to watch what the other system are doing around you so you can keep up with them.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Don't get me there and leave me there.
Right. Mm-hmm. And that kind of came in over the last 10 years where we've become competitive with our salaries with the other parishes.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, we want
it
our
It wasn't always
stay.
That way, was it, Mr. Joseph?
No. We want our teachers to stay home. Ugh. Yeah.
You want to call this play for us, Mr. Joseph?
Yeah, let's see what we got. All right.
That is Brody Inerarity at quarterback for Independence.
Yeah, I like his arm strength. He's been throwing it pretty good. All right.
Of course, Amite looking to go back to the dome again.
Well, Amite is always strong, and they got something you can't coach called speed.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, Mr. Joseph, I can't take away from the feeder school.
Yeah,
the feeder school is the catch.
Exactly, right.
AB has an outstanding feeder
school. It starts at that level.
Yes, and sir. An excellent coaching staff and Coach Powell and his staff.
Right.
They do it. They put their heart in it.
No doubt about it.
I remember Coach Powell when he was at Sumner.
Oh, yes.
And I said, heard this there. Guy's going to be good.
Uh-huh. See, that's a nice fake he just made. He bought some time. Had not he rolled out, he would have been sacked. He bought some time when he rolled out. Quarterback got to have some pretty good foot speed, too, to get to the outside.
Throwing across his body on the run.
On the run.
Hit number 13, Jalen James, sophomore running back.
James made a good catch at that, too.
Injury do right, don't
he sacrificed his body. It looks like he's injured somewhere. Probably get the wind knocked out of him. Nice play.
Well, Mr. Joseph, I can't tell you what an honor it was to – we've spoken before, but to speak on camera, it's just an honor for me because I grew up admiring you,
through
Dad and everything.
Thank you.
And again, thank you so much for what you've done for Tansville Parish.
Yes, thank you so much.
And for our country.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Yes, sir.
I really do.
And
thank you.
I invited Mr. Lockett.
Uh-huh.
We would be honored, I'm sure Jeff would as well, for you to come talk to our Jack
students. Oh, that would be an excellent.
Oh, yes, indeed. Oh, man.
I have, we have to have eight guest speakers
eight
over the course of the
minimum,
year?
We can have as many as we want, but we can have 20 if we can get them to come.
And we would
it's
love
hard
to
get people to sacrifice their time.
Just let me know. That's what I do, though.
Yes, sir.
Matter of fact, I was at the TASS graduation this morning.
Praise God.
And I left there and went to military ROTC program in Southeastern today.
Praise
I'm all over the place.
Oh, yes,
so you knew
sir.
Carl Ingram real well.
Oh, yeah. Carl,
I was tight, man. God, I think Carl Ingram a long time.
Yeah, unfortunately, he passed away.
He did.
Bless his heart.
I grew up with his son, York.
Right.
Well, I worked with him at TASS in the early days.
And I think his daughter-in-law still teaches at Ponchatoula Junior High School.
Yes, sir.
So I keep up with everybody.
God, have mercy.
Colonel Ingram was a tough man.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I got to put you on the spot. Who are you rooting for here?
Both teams.
The ultimate politician. What a great answer. What else would you expect, folks?
Oh, yeah.
Been there, done that, huh, Mr. Joseph?
That's right. Been there, done that. But thank you guys for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you so much. You're welcome on our program anytime.
Thank you so much,
man. And I'll be in touch with you about maybe lining you up this fall.
Not a problem. Tommy knows how to reach me. Thank you, guys.
That's Mr. Louis Joseph. Thank you, sir.
one of our sponsors for tonight's game, by the way.
He sure is. And while we're doing that, I will lead off with this telecast made possible by Drive-In Drugstore, McNeely Funeral Home, Amite, Jim's Paint and Body, Clerk of Court Gary Stanga, Vivo CPR, Tanspo Parish Councilman, Mr. Lewis Joseph, David Ritter, candidate for Tanspo Parish Council, District 4, Heath Martin, candidate for Tanspo Parish Sheriff. And without these folks, Jeff, we wouldn't be putting this on air. Now, I know it's a spring game, and it's you know, it doesn't really count for anything, but they got me and Randy out here anyway.
Sweating.
Yes.
Tommy's got me running. Go get a water. Go grab this.
You know, they said we had 100 heat index today.
Is it?
It was 89 degrees with 100% humidity, and
it was hot. It is hot.
We had our senior send-off today.
Oh, I've been blessed.
They got on the football field and lined up in the shape of a 23, 2, and a 3, and they took a drone photo from the sky and everything.
Oh, that's cool.
But we were dripping out there.
Oh, I bet. Well, you know, I would like to say that my son graduated Ponchatoula last night.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah, so I'm a happy father.
That has to be to feel good.
It does. It really does. You're getting to watch him walk the stage. And
not happy to decide his next step.
He actually wants to go real estate. He's actually trying to get into commercial real estate is what he's wanting to do. That's his next step.
That's not a bad idea. Real estate is very active right now, though.
He's going to do some schooling for that and get some his licenses and stuff doing that. That's his plan. But right
Tommy's
I got my job at Rouse's.
I don't know what he wants me to do.
Tommy, since you're handing out money, buddy. I don't remember that. Did anybody see him hand me anything? I don't think so.
Now, Randy, you still have a couple of our players, or you did?
I did, not anymore. I think they both kind of just did their own thing. One started going to school that's what he told me he was going to do. Yeah.
Kyle McGinnis. Yeah,
McGinnis is going to go to school, and I hadn't talked to him since. And then Jalen kind of got busy with work and life and kind of growing up, so that's what he was doing.
Good kids.
They were great kids.
But like I said, life happens.
Yeah, it does. And Jalen and Kylan were two of my JAG students at Hammond, and Randy fell in love with him right away.
Praise God.
And McGinnis was an interesting character because he never really he got some starts here and there, but he never really blossomed.
Right.
At the running back position with us, but when Randy got him, he really did well.
He really started finding his way as more of a north south back kind of and he was tearing it up. He was doing good, and then it stopped. He was having a great game. We were in A-meet, and he was having a great game. And then he broke one out the side, and when he went to break a tackle, he twisted, and the guy hit his knee, and that was it.
Ooh,
and then he recovered from that and then went to school.
Now he's going to school, and now he's going to try to – I think he was trying to walk on Southeastern, so hopefully that goes good for him.
Well, Colin's a very intelligent young man. Yes. I picked up on that right away, as is Jalen.
And they both have great support systems, and that's a plus.
Well, yeah, that is a great foundation.
Yes.
Both of them embraced the JAG program and took what we gave them.
Now that part, you got the love.
Now, we're wrapping up JAG for the year, right?
Yep.
You're doing all your paperwork and everything? See, I know. We have a lot of paperwork to do with Chanceville Parents, but
lots.
Triple that with the paperwork we got to do for JAG.
Triple that.
It's worth every sheet, isn't it?
It's worth every penny of it. You know, like I said, when you see the outcome, is it worth it. And you get you a system, but even with a good system, it still takes you a little time.
And there's still, and we discussed this before, as we see Amite on the move. Nice pass. That's number 6, Julius Glass. That's a first down. But talking to Mr. Joseph, you know, when we talk to our kids about careers and everything, when I get the freshmen in, I'm sure you do the same, I ask them, you know, what do you want to be when you grow up, you know, and most of them don't know, and that's fine, because there's people in college that still don't know, but when you find your calling, when you find that one thing that you're supposed to do with your life, you're not going to have a doubt, you're going to know what it is, and as you, I found mine with teaching. I'm certainly not a very good football coach. My wheelhouse is in the classroom.
I know I can't. I'm definitely not in that category. I deal with the members about having it.
And we don't do it for the money.
Oh, Lord.
Because the money It's okay. You can make a living.
We don't get no stipends now.
But when right. those young men and women cross that stage wearing that cap and gown.
That's where it means
and
something.
And they look at you and say, thank you.
You're right.
You can't. That's bigger than any paycheck you could get.
I agree. I'm not even teaching. I can agree with that.
Yeah. For riding them and take interest in when no one else takes the interest.
Well, correct. Giving them a sense of belonging.
Right.
Because we have the Career Association and – some of these kids never been in a club before.
And they had never had one. They really put them as number one. So they being number one in in someone's eyes, that's great for them.
Right. And they wear their JAG shirts with pride around campus. Yes, they really do. And I also ask them, you know, would you rather make a whole bunch of money but hate going to work in the morning? Can't stand what you do. Or would you rather be comfortable financially and do what you love? And some of them say, give me the money. And that's fine. Understand for what it is.
They're young.
I had a really good friend of mine, and it's glad that you said that, making really good money at Best Buy. He was one of the big wigs. He was, you know, up there. He's making lots of money. But he hated it. And and he went to a different job making a chunk less than what he was making. And I asked him, why would you do that? And his comment to me was, I would rather wake up and enjoy what I'm doing than wake up and not want to go in.
Very good point. And I don't think we know the impact they have on your health.
Right, exactly.
That has a great impact on your health.
Yep.
That pass completed to
Stress
Delshita Martin. Is that correct?
So now we're gonna start
Delshita
calling names.
Delshita Martin, freshman wide receiver, sir.
Yeah. So now we're going to start calling names? You've been a little behind on that.
I got that one. But, yeah, we're just wrapping up Teacher Appreciation Week.
Oh, yeah.
And we don't want anything, you know. But I had a young man. He's a sophomore football player, Elijah Harrison. Going to be a really good football player. Came into my room the other day and just handed me a little bag with it had a little koozie in it and some candy. And it sounds simple, but it meant the world
it was
to
from
me
this heart.
That kid took the time to come give me something. And it's not the gift. It's the gesture.
It's the gesture. Yep. Yeah.
And it just filled my heart up.
That is that's a powerful statement.
So in case you've forgotten, this is Alfab 17's coverage of spring football. We're covering Amite and Independence. I'm here with Randy Whitney and Mr. Jeff Johnson from the Amite JAG program. And, of course, behind the camera, Mr. Tommy Hazelwood. And can't forget about Grumps, right? Our producer.
Can't forget about Charlie. Charlie's somewhere around here.
We just got through interviewing Mr. Frank Lockett from the New Orleans Breakers and Mr. Louis Joseph, former superintendent of schools, Tansville Parish. So it's not a game that's going to count in the books. This will probably be forgotten about shortly, but we've had some dignitaries on the show, including yourself.
Well, I have to tell you, it don't count, but the one thing is for certain.
Who that? 15. That's number 15. You want to find that one?
Oh, Brandon Coleman.
That was about a 40 to 50 yard run he ripped off there.
It was.
One thing about Amy that's a given is the tank is never empty.
Oh, God, no. God knows. As I said earlier, though, we are so blessed to have a good feeder school, a great feeder school.
Yes.
We pick up over 100 students every year that come from Westside, and out of that, you know, it's like a gold mine. You get a 6'5 lineman, 270 pounds. You know, I'm talking about 6'6, you know, I'm talking about 6'5, 6'6, and you got two or three in that just young kids, steady growing. And you can't, it's almost like a, you know, somebody that's sliding you an ace. You got to work with it. You know, they need some work. But the bottom line is, this is going to be their slow year.
Right. But even a down year, they meet, still going to be good.
Oh, yes.
Somehow we knocked them off first game of the year last year. And
it came out good. But
it was a rough game, but they picked it up after that.
Yeah, y'all took over the second half, and it was no discretion that y'all came out there to play. Kind of threw the curve and be getting the first half.
Yeah.
But got a little excited.
It was a very competitive game.
Oh, yeah. But it was a good game.
Now, we go up to Amite to start our season this September.
Yes.
We start with them.
So you're starting Amite this season.
Yes.
I think we got the same schedule, so, either flip-flop of the so game from the places.
So I'm doing a little scouting. Right now. just a little bit.
Oh, God, though.
I can tell Coach Buckles, hey, watch that number, watch that number.
Oh, yeah.
And have you met Coach Buckles?
No, I haven't. I have not.
Do yourself a favor. He's a really great guy, and he's an awesome coach, and the kids have bought in 110%. And he's changing, has changed, and is still changing the culture at Hammond because we've been down for a long time.
Right, right.
And part of that problem is we don't have longevity at the head coach position.
That's not good.
You look at some of these more successful programs, and Randy, I'm sure you know this. Mm-hmm. The ones that have been there a while usually have some success.
They do.
Right, but it takes a while to mold them to the kids. What
it does.
Have.
They have to buy in.
To see the potential of the newcomers that come out, you know. And you stay there 1, 2, or 3 years, you know, I mean, and then walk away because you see a bigger paycheck on the other side. But then the next person got to start all over again.
Right.
You know, and that's not a great thing when your kids look at you and say, do you want to be here? In that case, sacrifice a little money, some time, and show me. Talk is good. Don't get me wrong.
Sure, sure.
Talk is good, but stay here and show me.
Well, we're going to take a break. We have a hydration timeout on the field. We want to thank Mr. Jeff Johnson from the Amite JAG program for visiting with us.
Thank you so much.
I look forward to hanging out with you this summer over in Louisville.
Yes, in Kentucky.
Kentucky. I've never been to Kentucky, so I'm kind of looking forward to it.
It's going to be interesting.
We were in Las Vegas last year.
Oh, yes, indeed. So that's the second time for Las Vegas. Though.
I won't lose my money gambling this year.
Lord bless you.
Thanks so much for visiting with us, Jeff. And we'll take a break.
Coverage of the Amite Independent Spring Game is made possible by Gary Stanger, Tangipahoa Parish Clerk of Court. Gary Stanger, trusted experience.
Vivo CPR provides CPR and first aid training to your group on your schedule at your chosen location. We'll bring the training to your office, construction site, church, hospital, daycare, summer camp, school, wharf, or to your TWIC facility. Anytime, anywhere. Saving lives matters. Vivo CPR.
Hello to all of the citizens of Parish Council District 3. This is Louis Nick Joseph, advising you all that I am throwing my hat in the ring for Parish Council for the final time, as we are term limited after this election. Be further advised that due to redistricting, the village of Tangipahoa and all of the city limits of Kentwood have been added to my district. I humbly ask you for your vote and your support as we continue in our effort to improve the quality of life for all of the citizens of Tangipahoa Parish. May God continue to bless you and your family. Thank you very much.
Gems Paint, Body and Glass is a family-owned and operated auto repair business that has been serving the area since 2009. Their goal is to provide high-quality repairs to all of our customers. They provide a high level of communication throughout the auto repair process. Gems also does Louisiana state inspections. That's Gems Paint, Body and Glass, Durbin Road in Independence.
Hi, this is David Ritter, and I'm running for Parish Council District 4. I want to wish good luck to both teams tonight as they play football, also in the upcoming football season. I also want to remind them, in this district is Natobene, Tickfa, Independence, and Laranja. So remember us in October, please.
Drive-In Drugstore, locally owned and operated for over 50 years, providing quality personalized pharmaceutical customer services for the Amite community. They are at 228 South First Street. You can give them a call at 985-748-8307, or you can find them online at driveindrugstore.com.
Gerald and the crew say, go Warriors!
Hello, Tangipahoa, this is Heath Martin, candidate for sheriff. I'm happy to bring you this high school football game. Come out and join us in July for our meet and greet at Serenity Sands on the beautiful Tashpole River. You can find the information on any of my social media platforms. Now let's sit back and enjoy the game.
So let me ask you a question real quick. What do you think? What have you seen out here so far?
Well, besides a lot of people talking up here, I've seen a lot of good work. I mean, you can see a lot of mistakes, but I've seen a lot of good things coming from both teams.
Exactly. I see a lot of speed over here on these guys in purple for sure.
Yes, definitely the speed factor.
Yeah,
I've seen a lot of that. I see Independence. They got some good players, and they're only going to get better. I think I was six seniors, seven seniors maybe.
Something
I think
like
is what
that.
Tommy said.
Yeah.
I can't remember what we were talking about upstairs, yeah. But they got a chunk of seniors.
Yeah.
And, you know, they've been around a while. That helps a lot. So.
Well, you'll notice how many players they got dressed out? 77.
What, is that for Amite? Hey.
Over there.
Yeah, Amite. Yeah. So.
Yeah.
That's a lot it of sure players. I noticed that earlier, but, you know, honestly, a smaller team, in my opinion, you can do a lot more with it. I mean, you may not have the players or the pool to pull from, but you've got players that want to be here. You can, you know, they're going to put in the work.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
I mean, it's more of a camaraderie, I guess you would say.
Yeah, these guys are definitely working their tails off.
Right.
Yeah. It's been a fun game, though.
Yeah, I mean, I love it. It's a nice night for ball, no rain,
right.
Beautiful, beautiful night. A little warm, a little sweaty, you know, humidity is a little up there, but.
Well, just wait a couple of weeks, you know.
Right, yeah. And it looks like a fumble, bad handoff or snap, maybe.
Yeah, they had a few of those. And
right. Yeah, so the run game I've seen coming from Amite is just, I mean, amazing right now. Their running backs are the blocking is outrageous. I mean, extremely good.
Yes.
And then the running backs have got a lot of speed to them, a lot of shiftiness, and making the plays that they need to make.
That's right.
On the defensive end for Amite, they're deep. The defensive end, they got some nice, good-sized defensive ends. They're fast. The coaching's extremely well on the defensive side.
Number eight there looks like he's a full-grown young man.
He does.
He can move, too.
But they're real disciplined on the defensive side of Amite. Independence, their blocking's not too bad. They've done a lot of quarterback sneaks, and Independence has, and they've got a good amount of yards. I think they're averaging maybe 3-4 yards a carry on a quarterback sneak
and
by itself, which is extremely good.
They've got two or three that went a lot longer than that.
Right.
So.
I think a couple was by 5 or 6. Yeah. So, you know, you're doing that enough. And so now that you know in a game, in a full-fledged game, you could probably get that first down if you needed it.
Looks like it so far, for sure. One of the things that I've been sorry about that, mm-hmm. that I've noticed for sure, is their timing's off on some of the passes.
Yeah, their passes. Yeah. Now, the quarterback situation for Independence is not looking great on passing-wise. They've been off. They aren't getting set. They may push the ball a little bit or been thrown behind the receiver. So, I mean, that's stuff that can be worked on, though, you know.
Yeah.
And, you know, we both know the coach over there. He's a great coach, and he's going to get
it
done. So.
No doubt.
Well, this is what this game is for, to see where your mistakes are, what you got to fix. So when the game does count and when it gets here and it's the start of the season, hopefully by that time you've fixed all the mistakes that you've had.
An old coach like you should know that, that's for sure.
I try.
Yeah. It's first and 10. Over the middle. Good catch.
A beautiful
nice throw.
Right,
good catch.
Right.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And I see, you know, he put some more work on that. And I really agree that he could take this. And like we were saying upstairs, and I know you haven't heard, just because they start today doesn't mean they're starting tomorrow.
Of course.
So they have to get out here and show. And they've ran through, what, I think three quarterbacks, I think, for Independence so
I
far
think so,
tonight.
Yeah.
And, you know, I don't think in my eyes none of them has stood out, but that's not saying anything bad.
It's also
you know,
first,
they just haven't stood out.
They've probably been practicing about 2 or 3 weeks, too.
Right, so. Right, exactly.
Right.
So,
and there's an offside.
But that's okay. Like I said, they just got to get a lot of work in.
Yep.
More work. If they want it, they're going to come get it.
Yep.
They're going to put that work in off the field. They're going to put it in the gym. they're going to get in here in their classes and they're going to get that work in. They're going to listen to the coach. They're going to watch film. And, you know, if they do that, come start of the season, they're going to be somebody to, you know, to compete with.
I have no doubt they will be. First and five now after that penalty. Flag. Somebody moved.
Yeah, and another, somebody once moved. Again, another quarterback sneak. And, well, like I said earlier, they're averaging about four yards a carry.
Motion.
That's almost, that's 4 yards. So you're averaging 4 yards just on the quarterback sneak alone. And that's not just with one quarterback. I've seen, I think every quarterback they've had done it.
Got to figure the offensive line had a lot to do with that.
Right. Yeah. You're getting that push from that offensive front, and that's good.
Unfortunately, one of them moved a little bit too soon. That's a 5 yard penalty.
Oh, is there a penalty? And I missed that. Oh, yeah, false start. That's right. Well, I'm surprised they let it play on the false start, though. Is that what it was?
They sure didn't blow the whistle right quick. I mean, I was surprised, too. But once again, first and 10.
Mm-hmm. A new quarterback.
It's wide open.
Oh, I love nice it. Play. I love it.
Very nice defensive play.
And some things I like to tell my quarterbacks too, is you know do your job, which we all heard, but let the receiver do his. You know, throw him the ball and let him make that play, put it where he can catch it. These practices that they've had up to this point, these quarterbacks need to learn the receiver they're throwing to and know what their capabilities are, because if they do, they know this receiver can go up for it. Put it where he's going to go up for it. That's put it out of the defender's hands. Make the receiver make the play. You do two things with that. One, you make yourself look good. Two, you make that receiver look good. And then that's good for both of you. That's good for the team and the school.
Puts points on the board, too. So, all right, once again, second and two, second and 10.
They called it a little early. I don't think he was down, but I mean, it is just a spring game, so
it's also high school,
right?
So.
Right.
So basically, maybe a yard, yard and a half.
What's up?
He got maybe a yard, yard and a half out of that, or did he get nothing?
I don't think he got it. I think he lost more than what he gained.
Right.
Maybe he got it right back to the where he needed to be.
Third and long nine, long eight, I should say.
What?
That's right.
You think they're going to go deep? Oh, we're going deep then. That's what we're going with. You got one safety over the top. They're playing off coverage. I wouldn't test deep, but.
Especially him.
I'd hit that short route to the short side of the field, turn and throw.
Yeah. And he's not. You got time. Oh, he's there.
There it is.
He's gone.
Amazing
he
play.
He's gone.
Amazing play.
Perfect play. Perfect throw. Excellent route.
And once again, he threw it where the receiver could make the play, right over the top, right in between defenders. Perfect.
Got a feeling it's a pretty good coaching going on these two teams.
I think so. A lot of adjustments, a lot of coaching,
a
lot of corrections.
Wow. Oh, after they do this.
Yeah, when they're done with this, they're going to do one quarter.
Okay, that's cool. I like to see that.
If they're going to do that, though, I would think they would, being that we don't have lights, they would probably get ready to start doing that pretty quick.
I agree.
Now, I said this earlier, these kids, this is a game for them. I don't care if it's a scrimmage, if it means nothing. These kids are coming out here. They're going to do their thing to be able to have bragging rights later on down the road, pad their stats, have people record them, whatever it is. For them, this is a game. To the coaches, it doesn't seem that way. For them, it's just a training exercise. But for the guys, no, this is a game for them.
Of course it is.
Yeah, they are. And they're playing for that starting spot, so.
Yeah. I think we can see who moved first. Yeah, it was.
I got you. Here, Carl.
This?
Yep. Give me the mic. This is Joseph.
We'll put you back on.
Thank you.
Put you back on the camera, technically.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Put it on, Charlie.
Look, now it doesn't move, and you look, Charlie, say something.
Why would I do that? Can you hear me?
No.
Yeah, he can hear you.
Okay, good.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, back to the game.
Second and 10. Right at the middle. I guess they got about 3 yards there. Makes it third and seven.
Third and seven?
Yep.
Yeah, yep, yep. What did our fearless leader talk about on the phone?
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's a great game so far. But I know both of you guys are veterans as well, and I appreciate your service.
Well,
we try.
Yeah, yeah.
We're looking at another one, too.
Thank you, thank you, sir. You know, we got the Vietnam. I belong to Vietnam Veterans Chapter 1052. Mm-hmm. And, of course, we meet on the second Tuesday of every Monday at the Golden Corral in Hammond.
Good.
And, look, we got a lot of activities going on, guys. We got put a wreath on our veterans' graves in November. We go down to the veterans' nursing home and our reserve and play bingo with the guys. Well, let's run this play first.
We still got the same quarterback, yeah?
Uh-huh.
He should tuck it and go.
And he did?
Yeah.
It's like he got about 4 yards.
He almost got the first down.
Yep.
So you're looking, oh,
yeah.
No.
Yeah.
From here, it looked like he got
it. Yeah, the angle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But people tend to look at the glamour positions on the football team.
Yeah.
The running back, the quarterback, the wide receiver, but you win games in the trenches.
You're talking to a couple of old linemen here, okay?
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
People don't understand. You know, you can catch the ball, have a pretty touchdown.
Right.
You can throw a pretty touchdown. You can intercept.
Right.
But if you don't got people in front of you, ain't none of that happening.
Nothing. Nothing
you
at all.
No offensive lineman. That's not happening.
And look, back to veteran. We got Memorial Day coming up on the 29th, and we put in flags on veterans' graves.
Good.
Yeah, in honor of those who died in combat. So we try to stay active and look out for our veterans. Matter of fact, today I was at Southeastern, and some of the family members, the offsprings. Oh, let's look at this play. Oh.
He's out there. It's too far.
And we.
It's pretty good coverage.
There were some students from Southeastern who graduated today, and they were able to go to college because their parents served in the military. They went to college for free at no cost.
That's
awesome.
Isn't that amazing?
That is awesome.
Yeah, that's a blessing.
It is.
Oh, you're a Vietnam veteran. I was
a
Vietnam era veteran. Okay?
Right.
They sent me to Germany instead because they knew what they were doing. All right. And this guy was in, how long were you in, Randy?
I was in 4 years.
4 years, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I tell people all the time, you know, that was one of the best decisions I ever made by joining the military.
Me too.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
I won't say, I can't say it was the best. It wasn't a bad decision, you know. But you also look at it too, when you get out, you miss the
camaraderie.
You miss that, but you also miss the togetherness.
Because
the outside world is not as together as being on base. And being a military, a soldier, because everything has to be a certain way. And when you get out of that, everything is not a certain way.
Well, you're right. Look, veterans understand veterans.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And a lot of time when a veteran leaves the military and gets a civilian job, he used to organize.
Exactly.
Yeah, in a certain way. But sometimes you have to realize that you're working with civilians, not, not military.
Right.
So you have to compensate for that.
There are other words you can use for them, too, when you first get out of the Army. <so.
laughs> Yeah.
I know I did.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it, it's tough getting out, and a lot of some, you know, especially for young men and vets that went to war and did the things they did. I was I didn't have to do that. I got out definitely right before everything started happening, and so I didn't have to see any of that. And but some of these guys still have to. I know you had to as a vet, a Vietnam vet. And you know, so getting out, you lose the camaraderie, you lose the togetherness and everything, that the cohesiveness of what your life has been. To go into something that's chaotic and chaos, and people don't understand you well. So that's why being a vet and being around other vets, it makes a big difference for all of us.
And you're closer to your fellow veterans, because and it could be where your life may depend on them. You follow me?
Exactly.
Yeah. So look, it's togetherness.
It's a family, is what it is.
It's a family, doubt about it. Yes.
First down. Let's see what happens here. Looking to throw flag on the play.
Holding probably. No, oh, that's a great play.
He got taken down pretty nicely there.
I told my drill sergeant once, we were digging foxholes. And my drill sergeant said something about a grenade falling in, and I made a joke. He said, so you would leave your battle buddy in the foxhole? I said, yes, drill sergeant, if he ain't fast enough to get out. That's on him.
Look. Yeah, I was a paratrooper, so I went to jump school in Fort Benning. And, man, it's a 34-foot tower that you practice coming out.
Yeah.
I couldn't come out of that thing right for nothing. That drill sergeant, come here, Joseph. Yes, drill sergeant, drop down and give me 20. See, I'm going to teach you how to come out of that tower. He said, I'm going to make you push Georgia all the way to China. So look, in the barracks at night, I started practicing.
Oh, it's got some move here.
Yeah.
Got some room. Got some speed, too. I got a flag.
My jump at night in the barracks, and I learned how to do it. Guess what he told me? Come here, Joseph. He said, you remind me of the time I used to come out of that tower. Well, I tell you, the military is so good to us.
We're going to let Charlie read our sponsors, the people that brought us here. And the only reason we're here is because of these fine fellas.
All right, this telecast is made possible by Drive-In Drugstore, McNeely Funeral Home of Amite and Kentwood, Heath Martin, candidate for Tenshmaho Parish Sheriff, Clerk of Court Gary Stanga, Vivo CPR, Big Frog Custom Tees and More, Tenshmaho Councilman Louis Joseph, Jim's Paint, Body and Glass, and David Ritter, candidate for Tenshmaho Parish Council District 4.
All right.
Outstanding.
Charlie?
Thank all of them for their support.
Yeah. Yeah, we really appreciate the sponsors because they actually allow us to do this. And
without these sponsors,
they always step up.
And this, you know, this doesn't just help. This ain't just for us. This is for these kids.
Yeah,
I mean,
absolutely.
Sometimes there's not enough film, and we film pretty good. So this film for them is a lifeline sometimes.
No doubt about it. And it's good community support as well.
That too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
After the penalty, is second down and 12 now.
That was a nice pull on that play.
It sure was. He's quick and tough.
Very good play. That was a great quarterback play for the pull. He pulled it at the right moment. That is hard to do.
Yes, it is.
The concentration and the timing and the patience you actually have for that is amazing. So that was great. That was a great play.
It makes it third and about 7.
He may not have got a lot off of it, it was just
more than he should have got.
That, like I'm saying, that was just amazing. That was a good pull. I love it. Yep. From up here, you're looking at it like, man, that's good. You know, their coach may be like, nah, I don't like that. But that's good. You know, maybe he wanted something else.
Yeah.
But from when I'm looking at it from my coaching point of view, that was great. That was a great pull.
Well, he's done a few of those today. He's pretty sharp out back there behind the line. Under pressure now, going to the right.
Oh, shit, low throw.
Pulled a string on that one, did he?
Uh-huh.
Sometimes running and throwing the ball don't go hand in hand.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's about it, yeah.
Well, they have to start over first.
Yeah, speaking of veterans again, we have soldiers that are deployed. My unit, my chapter supports them. yellow ribbon ceremony when they come back home.
Right, right.
While the guys and girls are on active duty, we raise money to buy the kids toys for Christmas. Chapter 10:52.
That's good. That's good. That helps them a lot.
Right.
Well, it sure wasn't like that when we got out, was it?
Oh, no, 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 no.
Hey, I'm walking out of the airport in D.C., and a guy walks up to me and spits on me.
Said what?
He spit on me because I was in uniform. He shouldn't have done that. He paid for it.
The way veterans are treated nowadays to then, back then, it's a lot different.
Yeah, but let me tell you guys this. The way they're treated now, it is great, but the Vietnam veterans have a lot to do with that.
Right.
Because we stood up for what we thought was best for our fellow veteran. We worked it through the system. We got our military organization to fight Congress to give us our benefits.
Right.
So I'm going to give credit to the Vietnam veteran. They gave us hell when we got back, but we benefit now from it, but our fellow soldiers now also benefit from it.
Right.
Absolutely. And they should.
Yes, sir. We taught them how to treat veterans. Yeah.
That's a plus for me.
Exactly.
There you go. I believe it was.
That's right. You're a witness. Right. You benefit from it.
I still, to this day, though, I'll sit in a diner or a restaurant, and somebody walks up to me and says, "Thank you for your service." If I have my hat on, and I just don't know how to take it. I still, to this day, thank you, but it still makes me, like, to me, you know, I did what I had to do.
You know what I say?
You know, I don't need that. That's just how I felt about it.
You know
it,
what I say? You know. Thank you. That's it.
Uh-huh.
I just got on the phone with Coach Buckles. Told me to tell you hello. Dorsett?
Yeah, Dorsett Buckles. Yeah. Great guy. Great guy. An outstanding football player. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
He's really turned things around at Hampton Heights.
Yeah.
He's brought a new culture in.
Yeah, look, we're all pulling for him. Yeah, Coach is a great guy. A tremendous football player over here. And in college, too.
Coach Buckles was Nick Saban's first recruit at LSU.
Not that right.
Almost made it.
That Buckles name's well known around this area.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But, look, actually, Tangible Parish had put out some outstanding athletes, though, from Kentwood all the way down to Punxsutawney. I mean, we're known for that. If you're a head college football coach, you better come out here and watch these kids play.
But there's something in the water on the north end of the parish. I don't know what it is.
Well, there's a young man just graduated from Tulane that's in the NFL now.
Tajay Spears.
Yeah, see him.
He went to Punxsutawney. Yeah. I was kind of disappointed that the Saints didn't snap.
Yeah, I was getting. See, Matt, on the north end, though, the grass is a little greener, the air's a little cleaner, and the strawberry wine's a little sweeter.
Oh, I love it.
There he goes.
So keep that head up.
I'm going to take a microphone and go down to the field and see if I can grab a couple of interviews.
It's about a 25-yard gain there.
I have to thank you, Mr. Joseph. It's been an honor. It's been a pleasure talking to you. I appreciate everything you've said and all the information you give me today.
Well, thank you, guys. And let me tell you this. Whatever I can do for veterans, if I can do it, God knows I will do it. My phone number is 985-320-5784. That's what I do. And believe it or not, and I'm not kidding, people think I work for the VA. Hmm. But I love it. That means I'm effective and I'm helping my fellow veterans. Yes, sir.
I don't want to say anything controversial here, but they don't work like you at the VA.
Thank you, Charlie.
You're welcome.
All right, so as we run out of light, it's going slowly. Yeah. We are still running the summer scrimmage part of this. Good defense. Did he catch that? He did catch that. Great. And that was a catch?
Yes, it was definitely a catch.
That was definitely a catch. Yep. Great concentration by the receiver, the DB. I thought the DB came down with that pick, and he did not. So I'm down a little bit further so I didn't get a good angle of that. Hopefully Tommy got that angle, and I could watch it later.
Yeah, I'll be watching it again because it was beautiful.
Right now, Matt is down there on the field somewhere going to get an interview for – ASVAB-17.
Hello, Tashboho. This is Heath Martin, candidate for Sheriff. I'm happy to bring you this high school football game. Come out and join us in July for our meet and greet at Serenity Sands on the beautiful Tashboho River. You can find the information on any of my social media platforms. Now let's sit back and enjoy the game.
Vivo CPR provides CPR and first aid training to your group, on your schedule, at your chosen location. We'll bring the training to your office, construction site, church, hospital, daycare, summer camp, school, wharf, or to your TWIC facility. Anytime, anywhere. Saving lives matters. Vivo CPR.
Hi, this is David Ritter, and I'm running for Parish Council, District 4. I want to wish good luck to both teams tonight as they play football, also in the upcoming football season. I also want to remind them, in this district is Natobene, Tickfall, Independence, and Laranja. So remember us in October, please.
Hello to all of the citizens of Parish Council, District 3. This is Louis Nick Joseph, advising you all that I am throwing my hat in the ring for Parish Council for the final time, as we are term limited after this election. Be further advised that due to redistricting, the village of Tangipahoa and all of the city limits of Kentwood have been added to my district. I humbly ask you for your vote and your support as we continue in our effort to improve the quality of life for all of the citizens of Tangipahoa Parish. May God continue to bless you and your family. Thank you very much.
Big Frog Custom T-Shirt and More specializes in direct-to-garment printing on custom T-shirts and apparel. Big Frog offers custom apparel at affordable prices with no minimums, no setup fees, free graphic design, and quick turnarounds. Big Frog Custom T-Shirts and More, Southwest Railroad in Hammond.
This is Greg McNeely at McNeely Funeral Home wishing the Warriors a great season. Go Warriors!
Coverage of the Amite Independent Spring Game is made possible by Gary Stanger, Tangipahoa Parish Clerk of Court. Gary Stanger, trusted experience.
Drive-In Drugstore, locally owned and operated for over 50 years, providing quality personalized pharmaceutical customer services for the Amite community. They are at 228 South First Street. You can give them a call at 95-748-8307, or you can find them online at driveindrugstore.com.
Gerald and the crew say, go Warriors!
One time, it was a young guy that's a freshman that stopped the play. So you got to give them credit. They only got in the end zone one time. Now, the only thing that scares me is, we're playing with 20 guys and they're playing with about 80. And, you know, we got an eight-minute running time. And if we can go 8 minutes, the biggest thing.
Hopefully the depth doesn't come into play there.
That's right. Hopefully the depth. But I'm telling you right now, we're winded and tired. You know, we done played a lot. They done played right now a bunch of plays. And we go both ways. And you look, we done played almost three quarters of a game just in sections. So my guys hadn't been off the field. So you got to give them credit. They're playing their ass off.
They are. They are playing. And I'm sure you're pleased with the production of we're looking at the Weatherspoon kid. We saw him come in as a freshman last year. And he looks a whole lot better.
Our biggest thing is discipline. That's it. And nothing else matters. With these guys out here, is discipline. And if we got four or five guys that's going to be seniors, and if they learn how to be disciplined, they're going to be good ball players. We're going to be a great team. But it still comes down to discipline. The one touchdown we gave up was because a senior gave up the play because he was not doing what he's been taught for 4 years. He decides we're going to switch, and we're in bump coverage, and we don't switch, but he decides to make a call, and they score. So discipline is our biggest concern right now, but overall I think we've done a great job.
We'll definitely hit that on corrections, huh? Thanks, Coach, and good luck.
All right, we are back. Thanks for the interview.
Well, I know Matt did it. Everybody knows Matt did it. Matt's been here all game. But thank you, Matt. All right, let's go, Charlie. We are back at it.
Well, how about that? It's about time. Let's go.
We are running, ladies and gentlemen. We are running a quarter. It's an 8-minute quarter. We had just started. That was the first play of
puck, right.
So here we go.
Good.
Once again, this game does not count, but we actually get to see them go at it now, and they're going to be putting some points on the board.
We'll see. Second down and a long 8.
You know, it's different. You don't got your coaches on the fit, or you know, behind you on the offense. You know, you're going to have to get these plays, call them in, and put some work in that you've been doing all day. So,
the warm-up's over.
Now, as the day went through before this moment, do you switch out your players and put certain ones in that's been having a good day to see what they do in the first team? That's the question.
That one went nowhere. Back to the line of scrimmage, possibly
about
a half
about
yard.
About 2 yards. That was about two yards.
Okay,
in that.
I see it now, yeah. Okay.
Once again, you know, another. Looks like.
He's getting up.
All right, that's a good sign.
That's the second time he's been down.
Is he getting off limping?
Yep.
Doesn't look too bad. Like somebody may have fell on his foot, ankle, leg the wrong way. It happens.
Third and 6 or so.
Especially if you're in that pile.
Huh. Yeah, tell me about it.
There's a lot going on.
That was a cleat.
Yeah.
Clock running at 6:12 to go. Under pressure, throws the ball and to an ill receiver.
You know, that definitely could have been a flag.
Yeah.
That should be an intentional grounding call because he threw it to a lineman.
Yeah.
It didn't get across the line of scrimmage.
Yep.
I didn't see a receiver in the area, so.
I think they let that go.
But, you know, they may not call that during this, what they're doing here.
Timeout right now. Clock's
still running. Not going to allow them to punt?
They haven't punted all day. Huh? They haven't punted all day.
They give them 35 yards is what Tommy was telling us.
Okay.
So there will be no punt. So apparently we will not be doing special teams.
Right.
Which I don't know if I personally agree with that. You know, maybe for the scrimmage part of it that we've done most of the day so far. But for the quarter, I still think punting and kick – well, I don't know about the kick return, but a punt or field goal, stuff like that should be allowed. That way you can kind of see, gauge that punt and what your punter in the blocking scheme looks like.
Clock is still running. It's right at 5 minutes now. Exactly.
Special teams could cost you a game. It definitely can. So, you know, that's something they should probably put in, I would think, later. I would say, you know, that's just me. But
went over right tackle, went inside the right tackle, went back outside, got about 3 yards.
No, it looks like they gave him, that was more Charlie, look at the sideline.
Oh, yeah, there. Yeah, okay.
That's about 6 7. Yards on that.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right, 6.
From this angle where we're sitting, it doesn't look, you know, it didn't look that far, but down there, I mean, it's different when you're on the field, I guess.
Right, it is. Second down, clock running, 4:13. Breaks inside the block and got about 1.5, 2 yards.
Right. So, Amite's running game is not bad. It's looking really good right now.
Right.
Blocking schemes, they're all there. It's all together. We're looking at a third down and 3?
That's so. About 3, yeah.
I like to try to get him to jump. I like that.
Yeah.
And a short pass to the outside. Should get him the first down.
It's close. Yeah, it looks like where he's standing. He's got it.
Yep, and there's a flag on the field, so we're going to do some laundry. I'm going to assume it's on the defense is what it's looking like.
Offside, maybe?
Yep.
Yep,
it
is.
On the defense?
It's a five-yard penalty, so.
Yes, it is. So you want to keep the penalties down.
Yeah.
The best you can. Now, is this going to be an 8.25? Because if that, I mean, that's almost over. I mean, they all got the ball one time. So.
See, the clock is running. It has not stopped.
Yeah, I don't know. Were they supposed to run the clock?
I have no idea. Where they are supposed to or not.
Maybe because it is getting dark. Like I said, there is no powers. We have no lights.
He's been getting that all day. All day long. That young man is very quick.
Very, very shifty. Very quick. They got a nice little game, run game. I love seeing what Amite's doing right now.
Yep.
Hopefully, it translates into the season for something good for them.
Clock running.
Tommy, I'm
going to
say, the Warriors over here on the sideline.
Hold them. And I think that would be a win for this defense.
I would agree. Nice one there. Out of bounds. Should be, first down.
Uh-huh.
First down.
First down, yeah. And they're steadily moving in these 2 minutes.
Yep.
Now, I mean, you could let them score and try to get your offense back on the field.
I'm betting this defense doesn't want to do that.
I mean, you wouldn't want to, not in this game. You want to try to get stopped. But
stop there.
You know, it's a coaching strategy. You could just be like, you know, game means nothing. Let them score.
Right. No, you got about a yard and a half, 2 yards.
We're going to toss this over to Matt on the far side of the field.
On the sideline with some of the 18 Warriors here. What's your name and what year?
Jeffrey Ashton, graduation year 2025. I'm Javen Ashton, Jeffrey Ashton's brother, and I graduated 2026.
Caden Smith, graduation of 2024.
I think our team's doing good.
Yes, sir. We're going to win.
They look like it.
I got my predictions. We're going to do good.
77.
My prediction.
Yeah. That's our counter when he came out.
It ain't going to happen like last year. Yep.
Guys are going to hate seeing that, hearing that, because I coach at Amite. But I'm good friends with you, Coach Powell. It's good to see him in good health, huh?
Yes, sir.
Y'all pleased with y'all's performance so far?
Yeah, it's a good performance.
Six units.
I mean, we can do a little bit better, but practice takes perfect.
Most of them didn't play. Yeah.
We always know Amite's going to be competitive no matter what. So best of luck to you guys, okay? Kick butt this year, okay?
All right. We are back. Thanks to Matt for our little interview again. He's just running all over the field tonight, isn't he? So, yeah.
Somebody must have fed him something today. He's really moving. Yeah.
That's why we brought you along, though, Charlie. You were supposed to be running the field.
Yeah, those days are over, brother.
Touchdown, Amite.
There you go. Finally got a score.
Hey, you know that? Look, you get 20 seconds on the clock. What can you do with it?
Yeah.
Give it to him. Let him throw it. Get your guy on there and let him dump it down the field. Let's see what, you know. Put a
As
Hail
my
Mary
daddy used to say,
goes.
Let him chunk that tater.
There you go.
Yeah. He was a Georgia boy. He was as country as it could be.
And he was Irish. Yeah, he said something about the potato. Chunk the potato. That's what us Irish do, right?
That too. Well, his daddy was the one that came from Ireland. But
your grandfather?
My grandfather.
Your grandfather?
Yeah. So the clock is stopped with 20 seconds to go. And
20 seconds. I say, let's look what the Hail Mary formation looks like. Throw it down. Get your guy back there. Let him throw it, and let's see what happens.
Somebody else said something about chunk of the tater, right?
Yeah, chunk of the tater, yeah. Only the Irish know that, you know.
There is that.
You know, I mean, if we were Scottish, it'd be chunk the saber.
Yeah.
You know, but we're not. We're Irish. Well, at least me and you.
Yeah. That'd be cool.
I think they will.
Well, I've been very impressed with these guys in purple all day.
Oh, yeah, they got a good play.
Yeah.
After the game, we go.
Too much time.
So after the 20 seconds are up, we're going to send this back to Matt while he's talking to Coach Powell on the other side of the field. And that's, I think that's how we're going to end our night. So let's finish up this 20 seconds, and now I'm going to hand you off to Matt. Maybe.
Well, we'll try.
What about it? He wants me, Ms. Joseph, he wants me to ask you about the touchdown play. What do you think about it?
Actually, I think it was a great play, but I got to give credit to the quarterback and the wide receiver. They got good camaraderie. They're working together. It seems like the quarterback knows where the player's going to be. Oh, picked off. You see? Oh, it looks like the quarterback knows where the player's going to be before he makes his cut. And that was a big deal. That was a beautiful play.
All right. Well, it looks like we are done. We're going to hand this over to Matt.
So I'm here with Coach Zeppanah Powell. Coach, good to see you.
Good to see you too, Mr. Gray.
Spring football, man.
Yeah, a lot of work, a lot of mistakes, both sides. But, you know, it's spring football.
And Amite. You know, we know the stable's never empty.
Right, right. Well, you know, we're young. You know, we graduated about 22, 23 seniors last year. We're replacing a whole lot. So defensively, I think we'll be okay. We got to shore up our middle. Had a bunch of penalties tonight defensively, but that's something that we'll fix. Quarterback play was pretty good. We just got to fix that. Young offensive line, young receiver core. So we just got work to do.
We noticed you have about 80 kids out here.
We got about 80. You know, we probably pick up some more, you know, once, you know, we get out of school, because certain, you know, some kids we had to keep them off because grades weren't what they're supposed to be at. So we'll probably pick up about 6 or 7 more kids, but you know, our numbers are growing. Yeah.
Well, we're here with Alfab 17. So contrary to popular belief, I'm not scouting y'all for Coach Buckles right now.
Oh, it's all good. It's all good. Look, whether it's a Hammond or to whoever, I mean, it's all good.
We open at a meet this year.
Thursday night. We're looking forward to it.
That's going to be great. It's going to be, should be electric atmosphere in a meet, and it, you know, it's going to be a heck of a game.
Right.
A lot of ties between you guys, Coach right. Buckles.
Right. Home, right.
And we all have a lot of respect for you, Coach.
Exactly. Same thing. You know, Tangible Parish football is the best of the best, you know, and we love the coverage that you guys do for us, and we're just happy that y'all came here tonight, too.
I was just talking to Mr. Lewis Joseph, and I said I met Coach Powell when he was at Sumner, and I knew the first time I met you, you were going to be successful.
Right. Well, I'm going to be honest, I've been blessed. You know, we had a bunch of great kids at Sumner, great administration, great community. It's the same thing at Amite, too. Great community, great kids, great staff. So I've just been blessed.
And most importantly, we're so glad to see you in good health.
Yes, sir. I really appreciate that. Thank you so much.
We thank a lot of you, Coach, and we wish you every success.
Yes, sir.
Maybe not so much against Hammond. No, I'm just kidding. But I just talked to Coach Buckles. And he told me to tell you hello and best of luck.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Go get with your team, Coach. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes,
have
sir.
A great
one. And that'll do it for our coverage of Amite Independence 2023 spring game. That was Coach Powell. We talked to Coach Shaffet earlier. And look forward to this September when Alpha will be bringing you live action from prep football in the parish.